Hello, thank you for joining us today. My name is Jesse. Today we'll be performing a modern men's haircut on our model, John. Today we'll be using Andy's products to perform this haircut. The first product that we'll be using will be our Super Ion 120 and also our Andy's Super Slimline Pro, both cordless for maneuverability, but with a rotary motor, has the power to get through the haircut and give it nice quality. To spray down John's hair, we'll be using the Flare Saw air can. It's a long-lasting, no-pump action. Want to make sure your client's hair is nice and wet. We're going to go ahead and start on the top. Be using a clipper over hand technique, so you can hold your Super Ion 120s facing towards your body in one hand, and also the same hand you can use your comb. With this particular hairstyle, you want to make sure that you slightly over-direct the front of the hair back to not make the front of the hairline too short when doing this particular style. Remember to work evenly from the front to the back, following your guideline. Now that we have achieved the desired length for the top, we're going to go ahead and start on the sides and work our way up. For John's haircut, we're going to go ahead and start on the bottom here with a number one plastic magnetic guard that Andy provides. This particular one is slightly modified to go ahead and fit our Super Ion 120s. But go ahead and start and put in a guideline towards the bottom and follow this all the way around. Now, normally for doing our haircuts, whether it's a barber or a stylist, we're kind of attached to the wall due to the cord. But what's nice about the Super Ion 120 is that it is cordless. So I am free to move around the person as much as possible to make sure that the desired length is even all over. But to avoid walking, you would want to stay in one spot as you continue your haircut, less fatigue as you're doing it throughout the day. Now that we have our level one cut in, we're gonna go ahead and start with our level two, again, attached to our Super Ion 120s. Many people have different names for this technique, leveling up or just levels. I like this technique because when you're first starting out in your barbering and your fading process, you don't want to lose where you're at in the fade. So this particular process of doing the levels without doing the fade can help you as you're learning and progressing as a barber or stylist. You don't lose where your level is at and have one side of the fade too low and the other side of the fade too high. Now, as you can see, we have our level one on the bottom, then about a half, quarter inch with our level two. Now we'll go another quarter inch up with our level three. Now for this particular leveling that I'm doing, I am doing a specific movement, which is more of a straight bulk cut, which gives me the lines that you can see. I do a slight C movement at the end of that line, so there is not too much of a heartache to get out later, but you can still see where the level is at. Once you progress in your barbering and your skills, you can start to flick very normally, making that C motion, which leaves you less of that level line that you have to take out later. Well, now I'm actually going to do a number four. By the time I get to this four guard, which is about where I'm going to be at, I am going to start to do a more of a flick motion or a C motion to start to blend in from the top and the sides. Normally I would be doing my complete cut standing straight in front of the mirror without moving around too much, using my mirror as the guide, as my third eye, as they say, because the mirror doesn't lie. It tells you where your fade is at and what you need to work on. John does do a slight part, but not a hard part. So we are going to leave it a little longer here so we can put that down. And then we're gonna actually take our clipper over comb technique and knock this hair down as well. For the back of John's hair, there is a little bit of cowlick on most of your clients. You will see that you will need to take down as well. And that's pretty easily done with a clipper over comb technique. Try to always pick up a contrasting comb color comb for the hair that you'll be using. This way you can actually see this technique even better as the hair sticks through the contrasting comb, color comb. Now that we about have our blend done, now we know where the top is going to be leveled off with the sides, I'm going to go ahead and work back down on those levels to take out those guidelines that were left earlier. There is a small weight line here, and that is from the 3 to the 4. So I'll go ahead and open. What's nice about these Super Iron 120s is that it closes from a 000 or 40 all the way up to a 1. So that's the adjustment. And with these, it is on the backside instead of on the side that we're used to with the lever. So all I have to do is flick it, and it goes up to a 1. As you're taking out the weight line that was left between the 3 and the 4, you will see yourself or notice that you will do some constant adjustments with the level on the bottom as you are doing your C motion, which helps to get out that line and not put in another hard line in your client's hair. Now that we took out the weight line from the 3 to the 4, we'll go ahead and use the weight line that we're going to take out. It's going to be from the 2 to a 3. Again, that C motion is very vital that you use so you don't, again, put another weight line in your client's hair. Always start your stroke underneath where that 2 is so you know that you're not going to start taking out any more hair. Again, as you're doing this movement, you probably will notice that you're doing little adjustments to the level so that it makes it nice and even. Also, you notice as the hair starts to move on the hair pattern, you want to cut in that general direction as well. That helps you to lift the hair as best as possible as it's going that direction. And I like the lighting better on this side, so I'll probably be doing the rest of the cut over here. So we're now gonna go from a 1 to a 2. So this will be my one guard on the Supra, and we'll go and blend this all the way up. It'll be. The level on your Supra will be all the way up to a level 1. So this will give me a nice blend. Again, your flick motion or your C motion should be in full effect, as I say. Always remember to keep your tools well lubricated. Using the Andy's Cool Care will help you do that throughout your process of doing your haircut. So by now, most of your levels or most of your lines that you have left, the bulk lines should be out. You can go back and cross check just to make sure that you have no areas left. The Super Ion 120s coming out of the box does come with a set of guards. It's a black set that fits perfectly on the clipper itself. They are a different style clipper than our, the head is a different style cutting blade than the Andy's Masters. So those guards are necessary to have so that you can use the Ion 120s. Like I said, I did a small modification to the magnetic Andy guard and purple Andes guards that come separately. Since there is a little weight that I do want to take off from the top, I am going to go ahead and use a scissor over comb technique to go ahead and blend that in a little bit more as well. The black guards that come with the Supras go up to a level 4. And so when you're getting into lengths that are a little bit longer than that, using a clipper over comb or a scissor over comb technique would probably be preferable by that state anyway. The purple guards, you can go all the way up to level 8, which is pretty long. I feel like if you're gonna go that long in the first place, you can just use clipper over comb, which is These are just comb guards. This is what they say on the package. So using a comb is the same thing. So I feel like I have that about right. And we'll mess with John's hair a little bit towards the end to make sure the style is correct. But the blend seems good to me, so we're gonna go ahead and I'm actually gonna taper this, the sideburns and the back out just a little bit. You'll notice that a lot of your clients, as they come in and you do one level, the sideburns and the nape area here in the back can have different hair patterns. So you wanna make sure that that's all level and taken down too. So one way of doing that is offering a taper to your clients to make sure that that's nice and even and that they can walk out looking presentable. Because even if you edge this up as it is, which you could, the hair in that particular area, the growth pattern would be a little bit different. So you want to make sure that that's nice and taken down. We are going to go ahead and just taper John out in the back completely. This would be with my Andes Supras. They are set all the way down to the bottom. It does say 4-0. It's a little debatable. But to not be tied down to a cord is a different world. And if you're worried about the power that it has behind it, you don't have to worry about that with these particular style clippers. Andy's did a great job with the battery life. It is an ionic battery, so you don't have to worry about it losing power as the battery drains. That's one of the things that why they moved into the ion battery instead of using a nickel cadmium, which has a memory. And although I don't have it displayed at the moment, the Ions and the Slimline Pro both have a charging base that you can use on your station. So you fade out the back, as you can see. Now we're gonna go ahead and do the temples. Just do the sideburns just a little bit. John's haircut's almost complete. We're gonna go ahead and do the edge around the sides. John won't be getting an edge in the front, but I will start on his sideburns over here. Try to keep his edge as natural as possible without digging too far into the hairline. These Slimline Pros were right out the box. I found that I did not have to do any kind of adjustments to them, although they can be zero gapped, which I know a lot of barbers and some stylists, they like because they want a nice, real crisp edge. After using them a couple days, I felt that it was set very well straight out the box without having to adjust them. It does take a little bit of time because if you're used to using your T outliners or your Andes Masters, which are both still great products, the motor in them are different. You're talking about a magnetic motor, so the feel of the clippers feels different. It doesn't give you that crazy vibration, which to many guys feels like power. So that vibration feels like power. That's that magnetic motor pulling and pushing the clipper blade or the cutting blade back and forth. And that took a little bit of time to get used to. You think that, this might not be able to do it, but it can cut right through, which is very nice. And if I did choose to, if I did have a little bit of hair left that I wanted to get even sharper with, you can go back in with you and do some razor work as well. So John's hair is just about where I want. Just look over, do any final touches. I always notice that after I do my edge up, for some odd reason, it picks up all the nice little imperfections that you left. So let's go over them really quickly. Go back into the dark spots. This is where your mirror comes into play a lot. If you're using, if you're doing a fade, a tight fade especially, your mirror or your camera, especially if you're gonna be putting any of your pictures on Instagram, pictures don't lie. Pictures will pick up all the lines, a little imperfection. So you want to take a quick picture, or if you want to just step away. When we're this close all the time at this level, sometimes we don't see what the mirror picks up. So you always want to make sure that you turn your client around and check your mirror so that there's no spots that you've missed. Okay. So at this point, you can send John off and on his way, but we're actually gonna do a little styling work today. So after styling your product of choice and showing your client how to properly do their hair after they leave, you end up with the finished product. A men's traditional haircut, slightly parted to the side with a nice taper from zero, actually all the way up to a level 4. With clippers on top. Thank you very much. Today we've also been brought to you through Exclusive Barber Supply. That's where we're at, here at the BAM Workshop in their classroom. And we wanna make sure that you go check them out online, exclusive.com. They have all the products that you've been seeing today. Thank you very much for joining us.